Hello and welcome to another session on Gems of Geometry, guys. So in this session, we are going to discuss something called the Steiner-Lehmus theorem. The Steiner-Lehmus theorem suggests that any triangle that has two equal angle bisectors, each measured from a vertex to the opposite side, is isosceles. Meaning, ABC is a given triangle wherein BM and CN are the angle bisectors of angle B and angle C respectively. And it is given that BM is equal to CN, and we have to prove that angle B is equal to angle C. That is, or rather AB is equal to AC, whichever way. Now, we will be using the theorem proved in the previous session to prove this particular Steiner-Lehmus theorem. And what was that theorem? It suggested that in a given triangle, in a triangle, and in the previous session we discussed it. If you have not covered that, I would suggest just go back and, you know, have a look on that particular theorem. So it suggested that in a triangle, the bisector of the smaller angle is larger than the bisector of the greater angle. This is what we learned in the previous session, right? So what does it mean? It means there is a triangle. Let's say there is a triangle like that. Okay, and this angle B, let's say in this case this is B and this is C, A, and B happens to be the larger angle here. So the bisector of this, let's say BM, will be lesser than the bisector of angle C. Okay, lesser than the bisector of angle C, CN, let's say, right? So BM is less than CN if angle B is greater than angle C. This is what we learned in the previous session. Now, if that is so in this case as well, then the bisectors must be, you know, greater than or less than each other, isn't it? But here we have been given that BM is equal to CN. This is given. That means we can't really say which angle is greater. What I'm trying to say is, if angle B is greater than angle C, let's say if it was the case, then BM should be less than CN according to this particular theorem which we proved in the last case. So let's say case one, right? But this is not true because BM is less than CN. Not true, not valid. Okay, case 2, if angle B is less than angle C, then what will happen? BM will be greater than CN, correct? By the same logic which we proved, again this logic, but this is also not valid because we know that the given thing is that BM is equal to CN. Hence, the only possibility is case 3. That is, angle B must be equal to angle C. Okay. So, this is the only possibility. Isn't it? So, hence, we conclude that triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Right, hence proved. So the major part of this proof actually came from the previous proof, that is in the previous session, whatever we have discussed. If you go through that proof, you'll be able to clearly come out with this result, right? So please remember, this is called the Steiner-Lehmus theorem. Now, if the two angle bisectors are same, equal in any given triangle, you know for sure that the triangle is isosceles, and you also know which two sides are equal in that triangle.